estás?
How are you,
Mr. Just
fine.
Hello there.
Hello,
Tutto molto bene.
I find you very well.
Yes.
Il lavoro fa bene.
Working is good.
Yeah, you look good yourself.
I get this.
Thank you.
Prime Minister Kendall,
Prime Minister
Benjamin, it's good seeing you again.
Well, John.
I'm your...
Oh, well, over there. Gotcha.
We'll have to...
We'll just have to small talk for a little bit while three waves of press...
Sí. Sì, facciamo la recita. Sì. Vedo che tutto va bene.
Everything is working out just fine.
Yes.
Sì, sì, ma proprio così.
C'è una grande speranza.
A great hope.
E questo è merito tuo.
And this is your credit. Thank you very much.
Certo che questo omaggio alla città del presidente aveva anche un valore simbolico.
That giving this gift to the city of the president had also a symbolic value.
Well, I'll be living in Los Angeles very shortly.
Sì, lo so. Perciò io l'ho detto.
That's why I said it.
Mr. President, assuming that the PLO lives up to its word on the resolutions and on renouncing terrorism, is it possible really to begin negotiations if Israel remains steadfastly opposed to dealing with the PLO?
Well, no, of course, because the ultimate solution does not depend on outsiders or us. Peace must be brought about by the involved nations meeting with each other and settling their differences.
If the PLO doesn't live up to its word, what do we do?
Well, we certainly break off communications.
Have the talks started?
Huh?
Have the talks already started?
No, but they have, we've named our channel and they have expressed their intention to immediately contact
you. Do we have any timetable for this?
No.
Mr. President, why will the U.S. talk with the Palestinians but not recognize a Palestinian state?
Well, because there is no such thing as of now. There isn't a Palestinian state, and if you recognize someone, it would be as that, it would be us declaring who was in charge there.
Could we ask the Prime Minister how he feels about this?
Thank you. Camera's display.
Io condivido questa opinione.
I share this view expressed by the President.
L'importanza di questa decisione è aver individuato un interlocutore per i palestinesi.
The importance of this decision is the fact of having found someone who represents the Palestinians.
Questo aiuta a risolvere un problema delicato, perché per fare una pace c'è bisogno di sapere chi sono gli interlocutori che devono fare la pace.
This helps to work towards the solution of a delicate problem, because to make peace you have to know who to make peace with and who is your counterpart.
Adesso la trattativa ci aiuterà a capire se le condizioni per fare la pace ci sono o meno.
And now talks will help us understand whether conditions are there for negotiation.
La decisione del governo americano è molto importante perché ha risolto questo problema.
The decision of the American government is very important because it has solved this problem of finding the counterpart.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Vuole che ci sia la mano, ma ci dobbiamo alzare?
Sì, grazie.
Ecco, così sono soddisfatto.
No, they're happy. That's good.
You timed your visit well this time. Days ago, it was just very cold.
Ma io credo che sia un po' una coincidenza fortunata. Tutte le volte che sono andati in gruppo a Washington, anche quando era cattivo tempo, poi quando sono venuto a fare le visite c'è stato sempre il sole, è lei che prepara l'atmosfera,
io sono responsabile per il lavoro di weather.
Washington. Italy is one of our staunchest friends and allies. I'm a little jealous he's been in Los Angeles. You know, I once told Margaret Thatcher that if those original colonists had come across that ocean out there, the capital of the United States would be in Washington, California. Well,
Mr. President, this is Dana Sokoff, the National President.
Hello there. Thank you. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Jeff Johnson, the National Secretary.
Right over there.
Warren Berger, the Vice President.
Hello, President.
Brad Chambliss, also Vice President.
Hello there. City.
Jane Hamby also.
Someone's got a beeper going.
Jeff Isom, another vice president.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Tony Hoyt, back with us for another year.
Mr. President.
Program specialist.
Thank you very much. Nice
to see you.
Thank you.
Put a couple more on the other side. Do we need two more?
Three.
Oh, that's great. Got it.
Mr. President, we are honored and humbled to spend a few moments with you today. You're one of the most loving, caring, open men this nation has ever known.
Thank you very much
for that. Tonight, the nation will join with you in this Christmas season in the lighting of the Christmas tree and in the spirit of the Christmas season. And we know that you will do a very fine job of representing our nation with that. We thank you and present you this plaque that reads, Mr. President Ronald Reagan, your love is for all persons and your light is for all time. Thank you, the National FFA Organization, December 15th, 1988, Washington, D.C. Thank you very much.
I'm very proud. I know your organization is the promise to us that America's future will still be the greatest agricultural producing nation in the world. And thanks to all of you and what you mean. And I just made a note so I wouldn't forget. You know, as the years go by, you have a tendency to forget things. Three things particularly. The first is, I've forgotten what the three are. Well, anyway, here, but I just wanted to make a note. You have some alumni that served here. Secretary of Agriculture, John Block, was of the FFA, and Malcolm Baldridge, the Secretary of Commerce, who's now deceased and left us, but he was too. And I have to get the whole title straight on this one, the White House Legislative Affairs Special Assistant, and that was Fred McClure, and he too was an alumnus of FFA. But I just can't, I've enjoyed every time I've met every year with your counterparts before you and now you, and I just want you to know how very proud you've made me with this. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Should we kind of move in a little closer and get a good picture?
Yeah, why don't you squeeze in?
Don't be shy.
That's great.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. And I know you probably, in the jobs you now have, traveled about 200,000 miles.
That's about it. Thank you for your leadership.
Thank you.
God bless you,
well,
Mr. President.
Thank you.
I'll miss you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. voice. Couldn't tell you what it was saying. Lots of chocolate.